Hi folks, this is Daryl Legacy, Instructional Designer at Hack. This video will show you how to create a rubric in D2L, how to attach the rubric to the assignment, and how to grade using the rubric. Inside your D2L course, click on Edit Course in the nav bar at the top. In the Course Administration window, scroll down to the Assessment category and click on Rubrics. Click on the blue New Rubric button. If you're prompted about using the new rubric experience, click on Leave It On to continue with the updated rubric creation process. That's now the default choice, so don't worry if it doesn't ask you. Give the rubric a name. Usually, it's best to name it after whichever assignment you'll be using it for. This will make it easier to find when you're ready to attach it to the assignment. For example, example assignment 1. Under Type, choose either Holistic or Analytic. A holistic rubric has just one criterion and is best for simple assignments. Think of it like a check, check plus, check minus grading system, or a completed, not completed system. For any complex assignments, choose analytic. This type of rubric has multiple criteria and allows you to have a variety of gradable elements, such as introduction, formatting, and use of sources. Under scoring, choose either points or custom points. In a points system, all criteria are worth the same number of possible points and are weighted equally. This may work well if you're using very general criteria that are equal in importance, such as organization, research, and analysis. If you want to use more specific criteria, and some need to be weighted more heavily, choose custom points. In this system, you can have each criterion be worth different points to match their importance. Type names for each criterion, such as spelling and grammar, or layout. You can add additional criteria by scrolling down and clicking the Add Criterion button. You can delete existing criteria by clicking the trash can icon at the right end of the criterion you wish to delete. Type names for the grading levels at the top, such as excellent, good, competent, or exceeds expectations, meets expectations, does not meet expectations. Note, you can add additional levels by clicking the plus button at the left or right ends of the row of grading levels. You can delete existing levels by clicking the trash can icon right below the name of the grading level you wish to delete. The rubric will continually save automatically, so you won't need to manually save or export it at any time. After naming all of your criteria and grading levels, you'll need to determine the worth of each criterion. If you chose a holistic rubric, you'll just need to enter a percentage for each grading level. Just like before, you can add or delete levels by pushing the plus button or the trash can icon. If you chose an analytic rubric with points, you'll just need to enter the points for each grading level, which will then be distributed evenly across the criteria. If you chose an analytic rubric with custom points, you can change the points for each criterion and each grading level. If you change the total value of a criterion on the far right, the default is 4 points, the rubric will try to match the percentages for each grading level to the new total. For example, if you leave all the levels as they are, 4, 3, 2, and 1, but change the total on the right to be worth 8 instead of 4, it'll match all the grading levels to the new total, 8, 6, 4, and 2. Be careful with this, as it could result in complex decimals if the old totals don't divide evenly into the new totals. After completing all the criteria and grading levels and their points, be sure the total adds up to the same amount you want the assignment to be worth. So if the assignment's worth 80 points, the rubric total at the bottom right should say 80. If the rubric total doesn't match the assignment total, it will still work. D2L will adjust the rubric total to proportionally match what the assignment is worth. So a student earning 85% on a rubric worth 80 points will still earn 85% on the overall assignment if it is actually worth 100 points. However, this can result in complex raw scores with several decimal places. You may want to enter a description in each box to briefly describe what that grading level might look like for that criterion. This is optional, but will help with grading and will also help students better know the expectations if you share the rubric with them before the assignments do. This could be as simple as contains no spelling or grammar errors. The initial feedback boxes are just a place where you can have the students see automatic feedback based on the grading level they achieved for each criterion. For example, you could include a good job for an excellent or needs more work for a lower score in that criterion. This is an optional step and not necessary in most situations. At the very bottom of the rubric, where it says overall score, you can enter a name for each achievement level based on the total score. This is what will display to students after you grade their assignment using the rubric. On a rubric worth 100 points, you may want it to say excellent if a student earns 90 or more, or you may want it to say B for 80 or more. Just like the above grading levels, you can add or delete overall achievement levels by clicking the plus or trash buttons. Once you're finished creating the rubric, just click close at the bottom of the page. Since the rubric is continually saving automatically, you don't need to do anything else to save it. This will now take you to a list of all rubrics you've created so far. The last step is to attach the rubric to your assignment. If you haven't already created the assignment, go ahead and make it now, and make sure it is attached to a grade item. If you need to know how to do this, check out our other CDI videos, which I will link at the end of this video. Click on the Edit Course button in the nav bar again, and scroll down to select Rubrics again under the Assessments category. You should see your newly created rubric in the list. It should say Published under the Status column. If it says draft instead, that means it hasn't been officially finalized and made ready to be used. If this is the case, click the down arrow next to the name of the rubric, then set status and published. You may want to click the preview button in the same pull-down menu before setting it as published to make sure it is really finished and ready to use. Once the rubric's complete and set to published, we need to locate the assignment we want to attach it to. There are a couple options for this depending on what kind of assignment it is and if you have already created it or not. If you haven't already created the assignment, do so now, and you can choose Add Rubric during the creation process. If you already created the assignment, and it's a Dropbox folder where students can upload a file, go to the Dropbox item in the navbar. Click the down arrow next to the item and Edit Folder. Scroll down to the Evaluation and Feedback section and click the Add Rubric button. If you already created a grade item that isn't a Dropbox folder, like for a presentation or something students will print and hand in, go to Grades in the navbar. Find the grade item to which you want to attach the rubric and click the down arrow next to its name and then Edit. When the grade item opens, scroll down to the grading area and click on the Add Rubric button. Find the rubric you want to attach and click the checkbox to the left of the name. Then click the blue Add Selected button. You should now see the name of the rubric below the Add Rubric button. Click the blue Save and Close button, and your rubric should now be successfully attached to your assignment. Go to the Grades part of your D2L course and click the down arrow on the assignment you want to grade. Click Enter Grades. If a student has uploaded a file, under the Assessment column on the far right, there will be an icon of a piece of paper with an orange dot if you haven't yet looked at the file. If a student has not uploaded a file, you'll see an icon of a ruler and a rubric. Click on whichever icon is visible to grade using the rubric. If there's no file submitted, clicking the icon will immediately bring up the rubric. You can click on one box in each criterion to represent the grading level they earned there. After finishing grading, click Publish to immediately show it to the student, or Save to save it for publishing later. If there is a file submitted, clicking the icon will instead bring you to the submission page, where you can open or download the file. Scroll down in the frame on the right until you see the name of the rubric in blue. Click on the rubric, select the grading level for each criterion, and click Close. The overall score will be calculated and automatically transferred to the score box below the rubric. Scroll down to add any desired feedback to the feedback box below, and then click either Publish to immediately publish the grade and rubric, or Save Draft to save it for publishing later. The student will now be able to see the rubric showing which grading level they earned for each criterion, as well as the total score and any feedback you typed in the box. If you created overall achievement levels, the students will see that as well.
Thanks so much for watching, folks. I hope this helped you learn to make and use rubrics. I'll be making another video soon that will show you how to use the rubric analytics in D2L to better assess the skills of your entire class and specific students. If you have any questions, please contact me or one of my colleagues in the CDI team.